The Da Vinci Surgical System is the most advanced platform for minimally invasive surgery available in the world today. The integration of high-resolution 3D vision, wristed instruments, and intuitive motion control enable the Da Vinci surgeon to transcend the limitations of conventional surgical technologies, making new minimally invasive options possible for complex surgical procedures. Three network components comprise the Da Vinci surgical system: an ergonomic surgeon's console, a patient-side cart with four interactive robotic arms, and a high-definition 3D vision system. Seated at the console, the Da Vinci surgeon views a remarkably clear 3D image of the surgical field. The system scales, filters, and translates the movements of the surgeon's hands on the master controllers to four interactive robotic arms on the patient cart. The Da Vinci S-HD system provides a magnified view that is both three-dimensional and high-definition. The result is a phenomenal immersive experience of surgery. The precisely controlled micro-movements of the Da Vinci instruments are enabled by the computer processors of the system. These dedicated processors perform millions of safety checks over the course of a procedure for enhanced surgical precision and control. Da Vinci EndoWrist instruments are designed with a unique wristed architecture that provides 7 degrees of freedom for a range of motion greater than even the human wrist. This proprietary design enables surgical maneuvers impossible with conventional laparoscopic tools. As the surgeon operates at the console, the Da Vinci system filters out hand tremor and translates his controlling motions to the articulating tips of the EndoWrist instruments. The Da Vinci system also provides motion scaling that enables the surgeon to tailor the ratio of his hand movements to a corresponding micro movement at the instrument tip. The system requires that every surgical maneuver is under the direct control of the surgeon. Redundant safety checks prevent autonomous movement of the instruments or the robotic arms. The Da Vinci S surgical system adds to the enabling characteristics of the original Da Vinci to streamline surgery for the entire OR team. Da Vinci S provides fast, foolproof setup, including a motorized patient cart for simplified docking, simple click-lock cannulas, rapid instrument exchange, and an intuitive touchscreen interface. Intraoperative communication between the entire OR team is enhanced with the audio-visual components of the system. The internal view of the operative field is visible on the vision cart or optional patient cart monitor. These monitors can also be toggled to display patient-critical information or a tiled display with multiple windows. Proctoring is enhanced with the telestration capability. Notations drawn on the patient cart monitor can be seen by the surgeon as an overlay on the surgical view at the console. The two-channel endoscopic cameras of Da Vinci S-HD enable better 3D visualization of tissue planes and critical anatomy. The result is increased surgeon confidence and an environment that lends itself to greater surgical precision. LEDs that indicate status on each robotic arm, along with the user-friendly design of EndoWrist instruments, make intraoperative instrument exchange simple. Unlike conventional laparoscopic surgery, the robotic arms move around a fixed pivot point to reduce port site trauma for improved cosmesis and increased overall precision. The future of surgery includes enhanced visualization, superior instrument dexterity, and operative efficiency in a tightly integrated system. The Da Vinci S surgical system moves surgery forward with a new level of technical capability that enables minimally invasive surgery in complex procedures as never before. Da Vinci provides a streamlined surgical experience that benefits the hospital, the surgeon, the OR team, and, most importantly, the patient.
had a science fiction replicator to replicate tools. A tool on Earth all of a sudden appears in space. That would be pretty cool, but we don't have that yet.
Or do we? Theoretical physicist David Kaplan has found a company that replicates tools, and pretty much anything else you can imagine, with a 3D copy machine.
I'm in Burlington, Massachusetts at the Z Corporation, where they've developed a new technology that's similar to those replicators you see in sci-fi movies. It's called 3D printing. I'm here to find out if they can 3D print my crescent wrench.
We're one of the world's leading manufacturers of three-dimensional printers. Everything on the table in front of us has been printed in one of the machines behind us.
Printed?
Yes.
Okay.
Most printers will print things in two dimensions. A three-dimensional printer will then take that to the third dimension and make it something you hold in your hand.
Okay, I don't get it. And this?
That's just an example of the complexity of the things that you can make.
This moves.
It moves, and it was printed all as one piece.
This came out of a printer just like this?
Came out of a printer just like that.
What is the material that makes this thing?
It's a specially engineered composite material that starts out as a powder, then we add to it a binder material that solidifies those powder particles together.
These materials are the company's own secret recipe, a unique concoction not used anywhere else.
This is one of our three-dimensional printers. There's a print head inside this machine that ejects specific fluids for coloring different parts.
Yeah.
But we also have a print head for printing our binder materials to solidify the parts.
Oh my God. The powder is the paper and this binding stuff is the ink.
And then this tray here that it prints on will actually drop into the machine to give it that third dimension.
Okay, I would like to see that. Could you reproduce this wrench?
Absolutely.
It has moving parts here.
Not a problem. First thing we need to do is scan it.
All right.
You go take a look?
Yeah. Let's see it.
Here we go.
The scanner inputs every facet of the wrench into this computer, creating an image that will be sent to the printer.
Oh, that is cool. How accurately can you measure the shape?
The accuracy is within 40 microns.
That's like a human hair width.
Actually, a little less.
That's incredible. All right, so their wrench was scanned.
Here's the wrench that you did.
Okay, can you make that ring red?
Sure, I want to select it and paint, so now that piece is red.
I see.
Just that simple. When we're ready, we just go down and hit print. All right, David, printing's done.
Okay.
Let's take a look at your wrench.
I'm ready.
Okay, I don't see anything.
It's in there. Just reach into the powder and pull out your wrench.
Okay. Holy cow. Wow.
Yeah, there's a real wrench right
there.
Oh
my God, you printed this.
Yeah, came right out of the powder.
That's amazing.
So all that's left to do is blow off the rest of that powder.
That is cool.
Yeah.
A color 3D printer. I'm freaked out by this. It doesn't make sense. I'm holding this thing that has moving parts and it just came out of a printer. Wow.
It's just that easy.
This changes everything. So how strong can this thing get?
You could get strength just by infusing this with a little extra resin.
We could actually use it as a tool?
Absolutely.
Okay, let's see if this really works. Can I really pull it hard?
Go for it, just as you would a real wrench.
Okay.
What do you think?
Wow. That's a real tool?
Yeah.
Holy cow. We just printed this.
That's right. An hour and a half ago, that was nothing but a bunch of powder and binder.
There's a box of powder. That's
yeah.
Right. That is incredible.
Now you've got a real tool that you can use for functional tasks.
So going into space, you take a printer, and you can just print whatever you want.
That's right. Anything from the tools that you need or the actual object you're working on.
And I can keep the tool?
Absolutely. We'll
okay.
Print another one.
Okay, good. So if you lose your tool in space, you can print out another one.
We developed a nano quadrotor capable of agile flight. Multiple vehicles can fly as a formation. we developed a method to transition between formations in 3D. The team can also navigate in environments with obstacles.
Future of construction, a flying robot building a wall. The demonstration took place in Orléans in France in front of an audience. It's believed to be the first such installation built this way. The robot's developers were led by Professor Raffaello D'Andrea of the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in Zurich. He says the multicopters use motion sensors to position themselves, but still have to avoid each other while picking up and placing the bricks in exactly the right place.
All of this has to be done robustly. It's not just about making a video. You know, here we're doing a live performance in front of hundreds of people over a period of 3 days. The system has to work. It has to be such that the technology is just transparent to you. You just see these vehicles fly, and it should seem like magic.
The multicopters recharged while waiting to be tasked. They would then pick up a foam brick, each weighing 500 grams, and place it exactly where instructed by a control program known as the Foreman.
It takes off. And it flies over to pick up a brick. It makes sure that other vehicles that are flying with bricks are not in its way, so it stays out of the way until it feels that it can move into the space, similar to when you're driving a car and you want to go into the freeway. Of course, this is fully autonomous.
The concept was devised by Swiss architects Gramazio and Kohler to develop a pioneering approach to design and construction. Matthias Kohler believes such a radical approach will allow designers more freedom.
I think it changes the culture of how we think about building a building, and thus changes the culture of designing architecture. That's why we're researching these technologies. We're not so much interested in automation, just more efficiency, but also the kind of, let's say, poetic aspects that develop through those ways of building, which you couldn't do in a traditional current building practice.
And this is far from traditional, but whether it takes off as future standard practice or is simply a flight of fancy remains to be seen. Georgina Cooper, Reuters.